going? Ramadan Mubarak, everybody! Today's video is related to motherhood and breastfeeding. It's something that's been on my mind for a while. A few months ago when I was in Egypt, which was in April, that was Hannah's first holiday, by the way. I think she was about 5 months. Yeah, she's about 5 months then, and obviously I was breastfeeding her. And we'd go out and stuff, and I would have to breastfeed her outside in Egypt, in public, you know, in restaurants or whatever it was that I was. And sometimes I wouldn't breastfeed using a nursing cover, I would just breastfeed how I was, because I wear a lot of scarves around my neck, so depending on my clothing, whether it was covering or not. You know, I don't always use a nursing cover, because to be honest with you, nursing covers are so unbelievably uncomfortable. I've not come across one that is super comfortable yet, especially when your baby's bigger. Imagine if you had to eat your food with a cover over you all the time, especially in the heat. That is annoying. So Hannah just always kicks it off. She's always fussing when she's got a nursing cover, so I try not to use one, basically, for her comfort. I posted a picture when I was in Egypt of me feeding Hannah, everything covered, obviously, I'm not gonna show anything, and it caused a little bit of a stir in the comments and a little bit of debate, which actually really pissed me off, if I'm honest, because it was mainly from Muslim women, you know, kind of like condemning me for breastfeeding in public in the first place, which I found slightly ridiculous, you know, fellow mothers as well. I just wanted to make this video to kind of like, for those of you who don't know what it's like having a baby or what it's like to breastfeed, to enlighten you a little bit, because it's not what you think. It's not like, hey, just put the baby on a boob and the baby's gonna have a drink and he's gonna be done. Sometimes it is, and when it is, it's great. Whenever the baby wants boob, they will want boob, and they don't care where you are, they don't care whether you want to give it or not. They're all they think about is themselves, because obviously that's all they're capable of doing, that's how they survive. I don't know what it is about the whole world. It's not even what country you're in. Here in the UK, I feel very uncomfortable breastfeeding. If I'm in a cafe Nero or something and I have to breastfeed, I'm like, oh God. I'm always worried about how people are gonna look. For some reason, and unfortunately in this world, if you're breastfeeding, if you're a mother, you're not made to feel comfortable. And it's rubbish, because breastfeeding is what your boobs were made for. They were made for nothing else. They were made under the idea that you may one day have a child and you will need to feed your baby, so it's so annoying when people look at you funny when you're just trying to do what you're supposed to be doing with them. And on top of it, when Muslims are saying you shouldn't be feeding public, it's not modest. Everything's covered. Why is it not modest? What I'm doing is not sexual. You think it's not modest because for some reason you've got boobs in your head as sexual. Unfortunately, that's because of society. Obviously, it's taught us all that boobs are for men and their sexual desires and nothing else. But sorry, like, guys, boobies aren't for you. They are for babies. They're for you when you're a baby, and that's about it. Women are made to feel like their boobs have to look a certain way or have to be whatever for the pleasure of bloody men. It's bloody shit. Why don't you just pump and fill up a bottle and give your baby the bottle? That's not how it works. For some babies, if that works, amazing. Good on you. I'm so happy for you. But for other people like me and my baby, Hannah doesn't take a bottle. And trust me, me and Sid have tried and tried, because as much as breastfeeding is great for bonding and all that stuff, I honestly would rather not be breastfeeding, because it's not easy, it's not convenient, it's difficult, it's painful. Sometimes you just want your boobs to yourself, you don't want anyone touching you, but you don't have that choice when you're a mother and you're breastfeeding. If Hannah would take a bottle when we're out, or if she would take a bottle every now and then, trust me, I would do that. Why would I want to make my life more difficult? You know what I mean? But she doesn't. She doesn't take a bottle. And I'm pretty sure there are plenty of other babies that refuse to take a bottle. Babies are quite smart, you know. It's not just like, oh, give them a bottle, they'll think it's boob. No, they don't think it's boob. They know the difference between mama's boob and the bottle from dad. They know the difference. If your baby doesn't know the difference or is happy to have a bottle every now and then, you're lucky, trust me. And in my head, I always thought, oh, I'm only gonna breastfeed up until 6 months. I've given up on that idea. I can't get Hannah off boob. She's on the boob whenever the hell she wants it, on top of solids. And you know what's crazy? Last year, I only fasted a few days because I was pregnant, and then the other days, obviously, I didn't fast. And so this year, I thought I could probably fast because she's now on solid. When she was about 6 months, she started having solids 3 times a day, 3 good solid meals, and I was so chuffed. And then when she hit 7 months, which is about 2 weeks ago, started introducing snacks in between the solids, and she was lapping up, she was loving it. I'm not kidding you, literally a few days before Ramadan, she suddenly decided she does not want to eat solids. I'd sit her up for her breakfast routine, clamp her mouth shut, does not want to eat, literally. And now she's almost only on boob again after being on solid 3 times a day. I don't know, babies are unpredictable. This is just what happens. She's going through some developmental stage, whatever. But this is babies in general, so I don't have my flesh and nipple out in your face, do I? I'm covered, and you could just see the back of my baby's head. Loads of comments were of people saying, oh, just leave the baby to cry. Oh, and give her a bottle when she goes home. I can't stand it when I hear Hannah crying. Like, why am I gonna sit there enjoying my coffee and the girl is thirsty, and because I don't wanna get my boobs out in public, I'm gonna not feed her? Like, obviously not. When you all one day become mothers, inshallah, and you breastfeed, you will understand. Back to the point of, oh, just let the baby cry. No, you can't let the baby cry. You can barely, like, it hurts your heart to let your child just cry when you can easily solve it and you can make them happy. You can't just do that. So many, even before I had a baby, I always thought, oh yeah, whatever, this baby's just crying, whatever. I didn't actually think of babies, like, with feelings. But when you have a baby, it's totally different. Like, you, if she's crying, like, you really feel like, oh my God, what can I do? What's wrong with her? Like, you don't want them to be upset in any way. Like, you really, it really stresses you. It really tightens your chest, you know? People saying, oh, just go feed in the car. Well, okay, first of all, why should I do that? I shouldn't have to do that. No woman should have to just go hide out. People saying, go feed in the toilets. You go eat your dinner in the toilet. See how you like it. No thanks. And I'm not gonna go. Okay, forget the baby now. I'm not gonna go sit in the toilet, dirty toilet, and have to put my clean, lovely baby in an unhygienic place with my boob and feed her. Like, I'm ashamed, or like it's a shameful thing that I'm doing. Why should I do that? Like, this is where people go to piss. And in Egypt, it's not easy to go park the car, go sit somewhere with your family and stuff, and then have to get up 10 minutes later to go feed in the car. Like, you have to walk in the heat with your... It's not a nice thing to do. Why should I even have to turn around and face a wall in a coffee shop? Why should I have to, unless it's a nice seating that they've got set up already, you know what I mean? And especially for mothers who have newborns, it's not just like, oh yeah, I'll just go feed in the car. Because you'll go feed in the car, and then by the time you've walked back to wherever you're sitting with your family or whatever, the baby probably needs feeding again. Somebody needs to make a cafe, or like a hangout area with a cafe and a library, and like, for breastfeeding mums, and make them feel comfortable. I don't understand why it's such a big deal. Basically, almost all my life I've lived in England, and I've worn the hijab since I was 11, and I've never ever ever felt like it's ever, like, anyone's ever judged me wearing it, that, like, I've ever had anyone treat me differently for wearing the scarf throughout school. Just a bit of bullying here and there, but never felt like it's affected me in any way. I've never felt like people in the UK have ever looked at me funny. It's never been an issue for me until recently. I don't know if it's because I'm older and I'm starting to notice things, but until recently, now I'm noticing funny looks for wearing a scarf. And especially with the baby, and especially when it's me and Sid's got Hannah in the baby carrier, we get funny looks. And I think it's because people are like, oh wow, she's not walking behind him and she's not the one with the baby. It's a little bit different to what they're doing. Like, I feel like now more than ever, I'm getting funny looks for wearing a scarf, and I don't understand why, because 10 years ago I didn't. You know what I mean? We're supposed to be progressing. But anyway, the breastfeeding thing just really, really pisses me off, because it's hard enough being a mother, it's hard enough being a Muslim mum, it's hard enough being a Muslim mum wearing a scarf, and on top of that, it's hard enough trying to do Ramadan with a baby, with a scarf on, in the UK. It's just hard enough as it is, so why the hell, like, on Instagram, of all places, you know, where you connect with people from around the world, you should be supporting this. And to all those women from Arab countries or whatever, and they're saying, we don't do this in Arab countries, that's why you're getting funny looks. You shouldn't be doing this in front of men. Why? I'm not showing my boobs. I'm feeding my child. Like, sorry, men aren't stupid. They know that babies get fed with boob at some point. You just look away. Why do they feel like they need to stare? In Egypt, they just wouldn't stop staring. I'm completely covered, so they're not seeing anything, but they're just making me feel uncomfortable. Why are you staring? And a lot of people are saying, that's why you're not supposed to leave the house until the baby is on solids, or whatever. Are you crazy? When I was having the baby blues, I was too scared to go out of the house with my baby, because I was too scared about not knowing what to do with her in public. So on top of that, you gotta worry about what people think when you're out with your baby. And this was one of my worries. What if I have to feed her in public? I don't wanna have to do that. And when I come to think of it now, I don't wanna have to do that. Why? Because of what people think. Okay, it's a little bit uncomfortable for me because I can't wear what I want. I have to wear button down shirts and all this stuff, and it's annoying. But the brunt of it is because of what people think, and that is an absolute piss take, because we're nurturing the next generation here. This is why so many mums turn to bottle. There's nothing wrong with bottle feeding or formula feeding. Some women choose it over breast, even if they can breastfeed. There's nothing wrong with that. But some women choose it because it's easier or because they don't want to have to, you know, breastfeed in public and all that stuff. And I totally get that. But what's annoying about that is formula is being advertised or being seen as if it's just as good as breast milk. But that's impossible because breast milk is like designed. Every mother has different breast milk for their baby. It's designed for your baby specifically. So I don't see how formula is ever going to be better for your baby than breast milk. They don't need anything else for like a year plus even if they're just having a good flow of breast milk. They really don't actually need, they can literally live off it. A lot of people agreeing that breastfeeding is natural, etc., but that just because it's natural doesn't mean it should be done in public, and then comparing it to changing your baby's diaper in public or changing your own, whatever, or going to the toilet, doing something, you know, like that, that's natural in public. Comparing it to that, your baby eating to having a shit in public, basically. Where is the logic? And a lot of people are saying, oh, you won't put up a picture of your daughter, but you'll put up a picture of you breastfeeding. Like I said, my boob isn't out there publicly. It's not like I'm showing you my nipple and then refusing you to show you what Hannah looks like. And sorry, there's a whole thing about me not showing Hannah's face. Get over it. Like, it's not your kid. You can't be sitting there telling me, oh, if you want to carry on vlogging and stuff, you've got to show your baby. No, what the hell? Get lost. I'm thinking about the future, yeah? If I keep vlogging and showing Hannah's face, like, you know, if somebody finds out what school she's in, it's all about safety and her future. This is not, it's not to do with me. My life would be so much easier if I could show Hannah on the internet. Trust me, if I made a decision to show her online, my life would be easier, not having to hide her all the time and all this stuff. But me and Sid made that conscious decision for a reason, and we're going to stick to it for as long as we can, inshallah. So people just need to like get over that. But anyway, back on the breastfeeding thing. I really think if you've never had a child or you've never breastfed, you really need to be open about it. And don't look at a woman who's breastfeeding, give her funny looks. Don't think, ew, what's she doing? Ew, she's feeding the baby. Like, you were probably fed that way. At some point in your life, you were latched onto your mother's boob as well. It's a natural thing, and more babies need to be breastfed, and more babies would be breastfed if women were encouraged to do it. And if women were supported, nowhere in the world are women supported properly to breastfeed. There's no proper support for it. It's absolutely rubbish. When it comes to Ramadan and breastfeeding and trying to fast as well, I posted up a picture recently also just being open with you guys like I like to do, you know, saying, oh, how is it going for fellow breastfeeding mums? I've only managed to keep 3 fasts so far. How many of you manage, things like that? And even under that, there's judgmental comments from Muslim women saying, oh, my baby's 6 months and my baby's 3 months and he or she's exclusively breastfed and I'm doing just fine. There's no reason why you shouldn't be. Blah, blah, blah. Or, oh, your baby's all grown now. She's on solids. She's on solids during the day, so you should be able to fast. You don't know what Hannah's routine is. You don't know what it's like, or you don't know what it's like for me and other breastfeeding mums. It's just crazy that this is coming from other breastfeeding mums. For some women, the majority of women are like me. They find it super, super difficult. But for some women, I don't know, mashallah, good on you, girl. You find it so easy. But doesn't mean just because you find it easy, other women do. For some women, fasting during the day will decrease their supply of breast milk. You make breast milk by the baby sucking on your boobs more, basically. It's like, the more you pump, the more milk you get. Do you know how thirsty you get from breastfeeding? And it's like I said, okay, you can try and drink however many glasses of water during sahur time and stuff, but half the time I can't even get up for sahur because I'm totally knocked out with Hannah. It's not easy, guys. It's not like what you think, honestly. I can just about get through the prayers, the 5 prayers a day. Like, I can just about get through that, let alone anything else. And then you got Muslim women jumping on you, should be doing this. Shut up. And another thing, there are a lot of reasons why some people don't fast, you know, medical conditions, some things that you don't see. I just read something recently, actually, about Muslims who have eating disorders and how they should avoid fasting because it can trigger the eating disorders again. So it's not just to do with a physical illness, it can be a psychological disorder. You don't know how they're worshipping, how they're making most of Ramadan in other ways, whether it be praying more, making du'a more, reading Quran, whether it be not any of that. Maybe it's just like getting through the day in general. Everybody has their own jihad, which means struggle, by the way, and everybody's jihad is a different level to other people. So For some people, their extra worship is going through that struggle or just getting through the day and attending to their baby, let's say. You get rewarded for that. I get rewarded for feeding my baby. Other people get rewarded for whatever it is that they have to do, and it's more struggle for them. You know what I mean? You can't expect non-Muslims to like us if we don't like each other. I don't know why it is, but it's the Muslim community that is unbelievably judgmental. It's just such a put off for even Muslims like me. Like, I'm so put off by Muslim stuff. It's terrible. Honestly, just quit. Be nicer about things, especially things to do with the religion. I'm really going on too much now, but it's really annoyed me. Hopefully some of you guys know a bit more about breastfeeding or understand it a little bit. But until you do it, you will never know how difficult it is already without people jumping on your back and telling you that you shouldn't be doing it in public. Get lost, mate. Until my next rant, I'll see you later.